Carol once again, and I am talking about evangelism today. Last week we've talked about street preaching in our class, and I will be very happy. Right now I'm happy to really tell you of what have I been learning. I'm going to talk to you about street preaching. You know, there's a lot of people in the church today that they don't believe street preaching. They don't believe street preaching is biblical, and they don't go out and preach in the streets and in the marketplaces because they just want to stay in the church and wait for these non-believers to come in. But when will they come in if we are not going to go? So today I want to share with you that every believer can know and understand that street preaching is biblical by observing these scriptures. Okay, in Matthew 10:27 it says, "Whatever I tell you in the dark, speak in the light, and what you hear in the ear, preach on the housetops." What you hear in the ear, preach in the housetops. It did not say that preach in your room or stay in your church. It says there, go out, preach in the housetops so that everyone can hear. Okay, another biblical proof is found in Matthew 13, verse 1 and 3. It says there, on the same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat by the sea. And the great multitudes were gathered together to him so that he get into the boat and sat, and the whole multitude stood on the shore. And he spoke many things to them in parables, saying, "Behold, the sower went out to sow." Here in this example, Jesus went out of the house. He went out and he saw, and this multitude saw him. And there he preached to them. What do you think? If Jesus stayed in the house, will this multitude will ever hear the word of God? Will he be able to preach? No, if he just sat in the house, he had to go out. And purposely, he went out to preach. So that is what Matthew chapter 13, verse 1 to 3 is saying. Another proof in the Bible is found in Matthew 3, 1 and 2. It says there, "In those days came John the Baptist preaching in the wilderness of Judea and saying, 'Repent ye, for the kingdom of the Lord is at hand.'" He went out to the wilderness preaching, saying, "Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven of the Lord is at hand." So John the Baptist went out to preach. Next is found in Acts 17, 16 to 17. "Now while Paul waited for them at Athens, his spirit was stirred in him when he saw the city wholly given to idolatry. Therefore, disputing in the synagogue with the Jews and with the devout persons, and in the market daily with them and met with them." So Paul here saw that there is a problem. There is idolatry going on. And so what did he do? He went out disputing, proving his faith, and refuting this idolatry of the people. So Paul was stirred. So from his place, he was stirred about this problem going on. So he went out. That should be the thing that, you know, we should do as Christians. We know that problems are going on around us, so we should not just stay in our room or stay in the church. We should go out and prove our faith. And the next scripture is found in Mark 16, verse 15. And he said to them, "Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature." This is a command. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. You know, you have to really understand that if we stay, we are not following, we are not obeying God's word, we are not obeying God's command if we stay. So we need to go to preach the gospel. There's a lot of scriptures. I still have one here as proof that street preaching is biblical in Jeremiah 11:6. Then the Lord said unto me, proclaim all these words in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem, saying, hear ye the word of the covenant and do them. What did the Lord say? Proclaim all these words. Proclaim all these words in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem. Can you see that? In the streets of Jerusalem. And saying, hear ye the word of the covenant and do them. How can the people do the right thing if we Christians are not doing what we ought to do, telling them the truth? Yeah? And lastly, it's found in Isaiah 58, verse 1. It says there, cry aloud, spare not, lift up your voice like a trumpet, tell my people their transgressions and the house of Jacob their sins. Again, cry aloud, spare not, lift up your voice like a trumpet, tell my people their transgression and the house of Jacob their sin. You know, we Christians, we are seeing everyone sinning and we shut our mouth. We don't want to speak because we are holy people, you know. And that is not what holiness is all about. Holiness is obeying the Lord and going. It's not to just act holy and relax and, you know, and yes, you know. But we need to go and obey the word of God. It says here, tell the people their transgressions. If you are seeing your brother, your sister, your neighbor that they are sinning, tell them that they are sinning. Tell them of their adultery, or tell them of their lies. And if they are stealing, you have to tell them. You have to open up your mouth and speak. Don't stay in your room. Don't stay in the church. So with all of these scriptures, there's a lot more of scriptures proving that street preaching is biblical. So you have to open your Bible and examine the word of God, because this is all about going. God is a missionary God. So now, street preaching is biblical, so therefore go and preach the gospel.